Good morning, California Seismograph friends. We're here in the studio of California Seismograph looking at our main drum. And this morning we had another earthquake at Lone Pine. 2 days ago we had a 4.6 there occur. And obviously that became the foreshock because this earthquake is rather a bit larger. It's a 6.0 as it came out to be recorded, but they downgraded it by 0.2 points and it's a 5.8 officially. It occurs to both our seismographs, as a matter of fact, as a rather large quake indeed. It looks like a 6.0 easily. We are up to about 200 miles away from Lone Pine, and this is a significant shock. Once again, as we see, we are in active area, an active moment of time here in Southern California. And as we here at California Seismograph encourage everyone to be prepared, we stand by the TIP standards to teach people about this, instruct and teach to prepare, instruct to prepare. Because obviously we all know, is this yes or no a foreshock to an even larger shock? Now this is not on the San Andreas Fault, remember, it's quite far away of it. The ground motion though obviously triggers far enough 200 miles to be recorded like this on our seismographs and is also felt quite widely throughout Southern California. And that means that the actual earth under our feet moves significantly. And obviously, as we have learned in the 1906 earthquake in San Francisco, the most recent large quake that we definitely all remember, was triggered by not more than the energy of a bicycle tire exploding. So remember that at any time we have motion in the ground, it is a cause for other faults to be triggered. Was never really understood as well as when we had the Landers quake, actually the double whammy, where at Caltech they came out to say the aftershock was not an aftershock, was a triggered shock at the Landers quake, the one after the Landers quake at Big Bear. That was a triggered shock rather than a shock by itself. It was definitely triggered by the Landers shock. So this is always a possibility, and this be prepared. As usually, there's simple things that you can do. Bring water in the house. I'm going to take you here at some of our latest, and you'll hear in the background the bells going, maps here. It's right at Owens Valley or Owens Lake here around that area. So it's definitely in the same rupture fault length. And this is not a triggered shock. This is a new shock, or actually this, let me go to your 7 day setting here. This is the 4.6. at Lone Pine, and thus this newer shock, the 5.8 here today, is obviously the main shock, and this is became a foreshock, which is interesting. We don't see too many of those. I might even call that 4.6 here a foreshock to that. I'll have to look into it, but it looks like that might still run on a different fault zone. Let's go to the faults. Or as a matter of fact, here's the Lone Pine that we just recorded and put on 2 days ago. This was for you to be seen. And that's, as you see, significantly smaller on our graphs. And the setting was also the same. It was during the day 1000. Recognize, as a matter of fact, how slow the pen motion is. A lot of people ask us about that. They say, you know, is that an earthquake? The most common question we get is when they see little things happen like these here or this here, they ask always, is that an earthquake? Well, obviously we are located inside the city boundaries and have a lot of urban noise. That's why we bring our CNS down, which stands for current needle setting, and that is at this moment 1000, which is usually the setting during the day. As a matter of fact, we have had heavy days that we even had to bring this down from 1000 and set it on 750, as low as that. And that means that you see less activity of our traffic noise here. If you look down here like this, or that might be, by the way, I would have to look back, there might be a smaller earthquake there, but usually these little ones are traffic. And you see that by the pen movement. That's where I was going with this. The pen movement is far faster than the pen movement you see with an earthquake. It's very controlled, goes back left and right very slowly, and that's usually the characteristics of an earthquake. Now let's look back our timeline here. The 5.8 at 10:40, just 5 minutes later, at we had a 3.4, a 4.6, we picked that up right after that, which is, we'll go and take you there, which is coming up right after this, and it looks like this, the 4.6, which is about the same as that what we saw yesterday. Here we go, there it is. That's the 4.6 that occurred 5 minutes later. Sorry, not 5 minutes later, the 3.6 was 5 minutes later. This one occurs obviously a good 15 minutes later. Came through nicely. Look at that controlled pen motion. Also on the vertical graph, you see that very clearly. And this is not sped up. This is literally regular speed. If you look at it, normal speed, and that's how the pen. If you look at our videos, often we do speed our earthquakes up. You see it in twice as fast motion. So then the pen looks like it's far more rapidly, and that might be deceiving. We apologize for. You know, usually we try to put it down clearly that we are showing this in double speed, but sometimes we don't record it underneath, or we post that. And so just remember, you can also see it here. If you look at just your regular second, your clock here, your seconds ticking by, you can see that this is regular time. If you would speed this up, which we do, let's go to a double speed, then you would see this clearly with double speed on also your seconds, you know, showing. So anyway, once again, be prepared, folks, and let your friends, family, friends know. Show them the site, if anything. Help them to understand that we do live in earthquake country. We have had definitely somewhat of an uptick. Remember, earthquakes kind of group. They like to gatherings. They like family too, I guess. They gather and they group in a certain period of time, and you have an uptick. And that might certainly be all over, and it is dead quiet again for years. Yet at the same time, remember that we are behind on some of our major faults with some major earthquakes to happen. I shouldn't say behind, that's an incorrect statement. It's more that we are past the regular average length of time at certain sections of the San Andreas Fault, down south by Salton Sea, and just above actually LA. That section 2 hasn't had a major quake for quite a while. And if it does occur, and we have a 7 or even greater earthquake there, being so close to our cities, that can have significant impact on the livelihood of our daily lives. And thus, be prepared. Pass it on. Let people know about our site. Let them see what it looks like on paper. It's a great educational tool. That's why we have our site live. And we hope you take advantage of that yourself. Make sure that you have a bug out bag at the door ready, that if something happens, you have to quickly move and gather your family at a safe location. Have a place together that you know that if cell phones get interrupted, if the regular normal social media ways of connecting with one another would somehow disappear for us for a little while, that we know, okay, we will all go and gather at the same location, at grandma's house, further away from the area or something like that. So make sure that you know all together what you're doing in a time of emergency. And that obviously, I think, has not only impact with earthquakes, but with any type of emergency that might happen. So it's great to have you guys here. Great always to see you. Be so supportive of our channel. We love you guys. Each and every one of you. There's several people that on a regular basis support us financially. You guys are so awesome, and we thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. You support our channel to grow. We have some incredible things coming up, and you guys are going to love it. It's waiting for one type of approval, and then we can make this public. So hang tight, you guys. Well, we thank you. We love you guys. Have a great day. Once again, don't be scared. Be prepared. God bless you, and we'll talk to you soon again.